Tian Hokkien Temple started out as a prayer house, located along the shoreline of the Toai Basin. In 1821, immigrants from Fujian Province, China, erected the prayer house and dedicated it to the goddess Ma Tzu, protector of seafarers and navigators.
Many early immigrants would get off their boats and immediately give thanks at the prayer house for their safe passage to Singapore.
Can you describe what this place looked like back then?
The temple was on the shore of the ocean. As people got off the boats and see the temple right before them. If you were a boat captain or a merchant, you would be invited into the temple, into the Huiguan offices in the back of the temple, where you'd be offered tea and business would be discussed. If you were a coolie, you would probably not even be allowed off the boat until your passage had been paid for by an employer here, and you would spend a year paying off your passage fee to that employer.
What happened inside the temple?
If you were a coolie and you had very little income, maybe $4 a month, then you would want to come in to make offerings, burn incense, ask for the goddess's protection, but you would also look for a credit pool. So the temple is a kind of a community center, all in one stop, looking for jobs, looking for wives. The temple was also the place where the Fujian Huiguan was established in 1840. A group of philanthropists who were interested in supporting Chinese education for the Chinese community, social welfare and aid, and promoting Chinese language, culture, and education. The temple was really a crucial center for early Chinese immigrants.
It wasn't just Tian Hokkien Temple that started this way. Al-Abrar Mosque and Nagore Dargah also started out as prayer houses along the Teloai shoreline for the early immigrants. In fact, these institutions still exist on Teloai Street today. They are testament to the various communities and cultures that have arrived in Singapore over the years.